Alright, so in this video, I'm gonna go over why you want to use date function in your formulas. So let's try to do some sort of logical test. We have some dates here. So if I wanted to compare those dates to a date in my formula, I would go here and do equals. And then if I try to compare if this is, let's say, greater than 11/1/2021, this is not going to work. Let me just hit enter and get the results. So you can see all of them are true. Now, the reason all of them are true here, you can see I was trying to compare if this date is greater than November date, and it says true, which should not be true. But the problem we're having here is that this is not evaluating as a date. It's actually a division. So it takes 11, divides by 1, and then it divides it by 2021. So we get this number 0.005. And then we compare if that number is less than this date. And because our dates are basically whole numbers, then it's always going to be bigger than this. So the next thing you would probably think of trying is to put this in quotes. So if I do that and drag it down, you see I got a false here, but now I get a false everywhere. So again, if I check, see, I was checking if this is greater than November 1st. So again, this one isn't, so that's false, but this one should be greater than. This is 11/3. Now, I still get a false here, as you can see, because now we have a problem that we check not against date, we actually check against text. So now we compare if this number is greater than text. Basically, it's doing alphabetical comparison, and in alphabetical comparison, numbers go on top, and then text goes below. So based on that logic, it's going to compare this and say, well, this is not greater than this. So it doesn't work. So one way to fix this problem is to use this date value function. And what date value function does, it takes your date as string, as text, and converts it to an actual date. So right now, if I close parentheses and hit enter and drag this down, this should work. So see, I get a true on this one because it's greater than November 1st. So all good, seems to work just fine. Now, the reason you wouldn't want to do this is that right now I'm fine with this because I'm using US dates. I'm going with 11/1/2021. But what if we change our date format for the spreadsheet? Now our format for dates is, instead of being month, day, year, it's day, month, and then year, like European sort of dates. So then we got a problem because we have an hard-coded thing here, text going on, and now that hard-coded text for dates doesn't work. So the way to make this compatible for both is to use date function instead. So you use your date function, and for date function, you provide your year. So I'll do 2021, comma. Then I have the month. Then that's going to be 11, comma. And the day is going to be 1. And now I can drag this down. It's going to work the same way because it's going to create a date from these parameters. And these parameters are always going to be where they are. And it's going to work. So now I have something that's actually compatible with different settings of spreadsheets, and I don't have to worry about this. And this is why when you have to hard code a date in your formulas, the best way to do this is to just use date function. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.